Chart of Accounts, Canada 2006. I learned how to use account in the chart of accounts and where and how to use them with the deductive method. First, we will learn how the chart of accounts logic is formed. We will detail them separately in the next videos. So don't worry, they won't be longer than this video. All you have to do is memorize it completely. I will give you the main items in detail both in writing and verbally. When you memorize the accounts in this video, you will form the basis of the chart of accounts, but you will also be able to understand the balance sheet and the accounts that provide data to the income statement. When looking at accounts from the chart of accounts, you will notice that some accounts do not have sub-accounts and how to use them is left up to the users. Balance sheet accounts. 1. Assets. 2. Liabilities. 3. Equity. Assets constitute all of the accounts on the left of the balance sheet. The accounts on the right are liabilities and equity accounts. At times such as year-end or quarterly closings, the final amount from the income statement is written under equity on the right side of the balance sheet. As a result of this process, the left of the balance sheet, the sum of assets, and the right, that is, the sum of liabilities and equity, become equal to each other. If it is not equal, there is an error, and that error must be corrected. I'll just tell you the numbers and names of the accounts for us to memorize until it's time for the income statement accounts. 1. Assets. 1-1. Financial assets. 1-1-1. Cash, deposits and official international reserves. 1-1-2. Accounts receivable net. 1-1-3. Investment in affiliates. 1-1-4. Investments in non-affiliates portfolio securities. 1-1-5. Mortgage loans to non-affiliates. 1-1-6. Non-mortgage loans to non-affiliates. 1-1-7. Derivative assets. 1-2. Tangible assets. 1-1. Inventories. 1-2. Allowance for obsolescence and decline in value. 1-3. Breeding livestock. 1-4. Capital assets. 1-3. Deferred charges and intangible assets. 1-3-1. Deferred charges and prepaid expenses. 1-3-2. Intangible assets net. 1-4. Other assets. 1-4-1. Pensions. 1-4-2. All other assets. 2. Liabilities. 2-1. Financial instruments and borrowing. 2-1-1. Mortgage loans. 2-1-2. Non-mortgage loans. 2-1-3. Debt securities. 2-1-4. Derivative liabilities, excluding employee stock options. 2-2. Claims. 2-2-1. Accounts payable and accrued liabilities. 2-2-2. Claims of affiliates. 2-3. Deposit liabilities for financial institutions only. 2-4. Future income taxes. 2-4-1. Future income tax current. 2-4-2. Future income tax long term. 2-5. Minority interest in subsidiaries consolidated. 2-6. Pension plans and deferred profit sharing plans. 2-6-1. Pension plans, trustee stock pension plans. Actuarial deficit. 2-6-2. Pension plans, non-trustee stock pension plans, actuarial deficit. 2-6-3. Pension plans, staff deferred profit sharing pension plans. 2-6-4. Other pension plans, liabilities and charges. 2.65 amounts owed due to other retirement plans obligations. 2.8 customer deposits, deferred income, deferred revenue from incomplete contracts. 2.9 other liabilities. 2.91 deferred gains losses on translation of foreign currency. 2.92 contributions to environmental trust. 2.93 restated preference shares. 2.94 amounts held in trust. 2.95 stock appreciation rights settled in cash. 2.96 all other liabilities. 3. Equity. 3.1 share capital. 3.11 preferred shares. 3.12 common shares. 3.13 owner's equity. Owner's investment, no share capital entities. 3.14 other shares. 3.2 retained earnings deficits. 3.21 retained earnings deficits appropriated. 3.22 retained earnings deficits unappropriated. 3.3 contributed surplus. 3.4 other surplus. 3.41 currency translation adjustment for self-sustaining foreign operations. 3.42 warrants and rights outstanding. 3.43 stock appreciation rights settled by issuance of shares. 3.44 asset appraisal increase decrease. 3.45 miscellaneous all others. An income statement is a financial statement that when you subtract expenses from income, tax is calculated on the remaining amount if profit and the remainder is transferred to the balance sheet. In the table, addition and subtraction are performed step by step according to the order of importance. It gets data from 4 revenue, 5 expenses, 6 gains, losses, corporate taxes and other items, and 7 extraordinary gains, losses, non-recurring items and adjustments. 4. Revenue. 4.1 operating revenue. 4.11 sales of goods and services. 4.13 other operating revenue. 4.2 non-operating revenue. 4.21 dividends. 4.22 interest. 4.23 other non-operating revenue. 5. Expenses. 5.1 operating expenses, including cost of goods sold. 5.11 cost of goods sold. 5.12 operating expenses not included in cost of goods sold. 5.2 non-operating expenses. 5.1 interest expenses. 5.2.2 other non-operating expenses. 6. Gains, losses, corporate taxes and other items. 6.1 gains, losses. 6.11 gains, losses on the sale of assets. 6.12 gains, losses on the translation of foreign currency. 6.13 unrealized losses and asset revaluations, including write-downs and write-offs. 6.14 gains on settlement of pension obligation. 6.15 gains, losses related to litigation settlement. 6.16 gains, losses on derivative instruments, including hedge revolutions. 6.2 corporate income tax. 6.21 current income tax. 6.22 deferred income tax. 6.23 provincial mining and logging taxes. 6.3 other items. 6.31 minority shareholders' portion of net income loss of consolidated subsidiaries and affiliates. 6.3.2. Net income loss of unconsolidated subsidiaries, affiliates, partnership and joint ventures, equity method. 7. Extraordinary gains, losses, non-recurring items and adjustments. 7.1. Extraordinary gains, losses. 7.1.1. Extraordinary items, gross. 7.1.2. Income tax on extraordinary items. 7.2. Non-recurring items. 7.3. Adjustments due to cumulative effect of changes in accounting principles. Thank you for your watching.